Quiet on set, we're trying to kill here. We're trying to do some killing.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
I'm gonna fall for it, bro.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
What's going on?
Let's meet our next victim.
Oh. Okay.
Tim.
Is this a setup?
Welcome.
Hey, what's up, man?
Please have a seat. We want to talk to you about some things in your life.
Watch
the microphone.
Oh, I feel like I'm at my auntie's house. How's it going, man?
Yeah, hey.
Hey, nice to meet you.
How's
it going? Yeah. Yes, Asian man on TV. I appreciate you.
Yes, two Asian men on a couch.
Yeah, I like it. Casting couch, yeah. Dude, I'm excited. I love your character, too. You know, I feel
Thank you so much.
I can super relate to that,
too. I got real lucky with this character.
Yeah, you know, I mean, anytime I see an Asian dude that's like not doing an accent on TV,
and yes.
Not kung fuing. Yes. I'm like, I appreciate that.
Yes. You know? Yes.
And he's a great character. Funny dude, morbid, kind of inappropriate. I'm like, this is me right here.
Yes. We need some just regular foul-mouthed, sexy Asian American cats.
Super sexy.
Thank you. Super sexy.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, man.
Yo, bro, why are you sitting so far away, man?
Well, because I know it's just a set, but I just want to, you know, get to know me first, man.
Well, we're going to be watching an episode from season 3, episode 5, which is called Turning Biminese.
This is like the first time that Masuka got a chance to like shine.
And I get it, bro. It's like just because you make people laugh and you make inappropriate comments, people think you don't have real feelings, you know? I can relate.
Let's start it.
Let's do it.
Yeah, you ready to chat?
I'm excited.
Okay. I got so lucky because this character was sort of the perfect match for Dexter's dark side.
For sure, the balance.
Know? Yeah, and you know, Masuka is harmless, but he can be irritating, annoying, and I think we all have maybe a Masuka like that in our lives. I'm sure you can think of someone. Don't name them.
I was gonna say, my wife probably thinks I joke around a little too much.
So you're more like Masuka?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Did you ever do any improvising?
I did end up improvising a little bit, but I'm always about writer's intention.
Yeah, because then they would have killed you off after
that. Well, exactly. Exactly. Okay. Bye-bye.
This fool think he's funny, huh?
Yeah, I know. Exactly.
Previously on Dexter.
I'm pregnant.
I just think I'm going to be a lousy father. I don't want to screw the kid up.
I'm still amazed how young all these actors.
Yeah, I mean.
Jason Elizabo, Jimmy Smits.
Yeah.
8 seasons is a long time.
Jen looks so young. Desmond looks so young.
Yeah, I mean, you look the best for sure.
I look the same, right?
You look exactly the same. I mean, you know, our people, bro.
You know.
Asian don't raise it. You know how it is. I'm 45.
You see? There you go. I'm 62. I'm not 62, by the way.
No, I'm not 45.
Comp tickets to my keynote address at the forensics conference.
Not really my thing.
I'm fleet combing my dog that night.
I'm seeing my little girl that night.
You don't even know the date.
Why's everybody being mean to you?
I know.
Wouldn't miss it.
This is the only time you see me very happy in this episode. He's the only one that takes it.
Yeah, Dexter, right? You got love for you.
Yeah, he's my friend.
Donut and a ticket to hear me speak?
I'll take a donut. You're bribing people to come to your keynote address?
The whole donut thing works for you, doesn't it?
Masuka. He's chosen the role of court jester. Now we only like him when he's making us laugh.
See, you make everybody laugh and they can't even support you, man.
I know.
Hi there, Deb. Help yourself. I saved you one with the cream filling.
Cream filling. Cheers. Cheers to cream filling.
You're like the foulest person I've ever met. Every line out of your mouth is a sick joke.
Yeah, so what?
So what?
What do you know? You're the fucking new guy.
Yeah, new guy.
I can no longer deny that I'm going to be a father. Up until now, I've been avoiding its inevitability.
Yeah, we're all avoiding fatherhood until it happens, man. I know.
Bro, I've got 3.
I got 2.
You got 2?
Yeah.
We all know what that. Do you remember that, the first time you got that photo?
Yeah, it was beautiful.
Oh, right?
Said, I'm gonna put it on Instagram immediately.
Yeah, exactly.
Front or back pocket?
You lost me.
The picture of the baby, front or back pocket?
I'm kind of obsessed about golf, so I've been there.
I'd be golfing.
Jimmy Smits, I can tell he's a real golfer.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know about Dexter.
They didn't let you play any golf on the show?
No, they never let Masuka play. Damn, they should have let me. Ooh.
Hey! You could kill somebody!
Oh, Jimmy's a little scary getting mad. Jimmy's he's a big guy. He's
tall. I don't think I ever realized.
He can be scary.
I mean, all tall people kind of scare me. Anyone over 5'8", I kind of stay away from. Just not my cup of tea, you know? Yeah.
Dexter, my hands are tied by the law, and the defense attorneys get to wipe their asses with it, and everything that I believe in is compromised.
I was so excited when they announced Jimmy was going to be part of season three. He's been in so many great things.
Yeah, OG for sure.
Yeah, and he's the nicest human being.
When it comes to my brand of justice, I don't have to compromise.
Oh, lefty.
That's what I said. Is he a lefty?
I
had no idea. But I mean, that swing didn't look too bad.
Yeah. For a lefty.
For a lefty.
That might explain why he's a serial killer. Lefties, man.
Lefties?
I don't trust them, just like
some people. My youngest daughter is a lefty.
Watch your back.
We tried so hard to get her to the right.
Just slapping the pencil out of her hand.
Yeah, tied her left hand in her back, but she's still a lefty.
I mean, Syl has offered to list my house with her agency so we can buy something bigger.
Ah, Julie, she's so beautiful.
I was actually thinking I might keep my place.
Oh.
Come on.
What do you mean?
She was trying to give you the...
That's a no-no. We're gonna get married and you're gonna keep your place?
Yeah, bro. That's like the red flag, though. If they don't want to move in with you, maybe they're a serial killer.
All I know is this episode, Dexter, he screws up a lot. You sort of see him getting backed up into a corner.
Screws up with women?
With women. And you'll see he screws up with, later on, like a pedestrian, like where he drives into like a car.
Whoa, spoiler alert!
Well, I mean, he like takes our mirror off or something.
Oh, okay.
Now remember, you two are just here to observe. There's a sheriff's turf. They're gonna investigate the scene, see what they can come up with.
I'm already acting a little pissed because no one's responding to the fact that they want to come to my convention.
Oh, come on. You know? That's a real person, right?
I think that's a real person.
Yeah. They've confirmed their skinning victim is related to ours.
You can see I'm wearing a tie.
Oh, okay.
With a button-up shirt, which I never... Look at it.
You're trying to be professional.
I'm trying to be professional. Masuka never wore an outfit like that. You know, it's always like Miami, you know, colorful.
Floral stuff. But now you're like, someone take me seriously.
Look at how big that tie is.
That's a thick-ass tie.
Oh, my God.
This is cold case I'm looking at. A dead John.
David Zayas, who plays Angel, doesn't he look like a cop? In fact, you know what? He was a cop in New York City.
For real?
For like 18 years.
What?
If you were in Miami, saw a guy like this, with that hat.
I mean, with the fedora.
Right?
Yeah, I mean, I would feel like he was an undercover cop that didn't have a good undercover outfit.
Exactly.
If you really want to know about paying for sex, you should talk to Masuka.
Hey, Vince, hold up.
This is my big scene in this episode.
Okay, I see the eyebrows.
I got some pretty big eyebrows.
Did you get a chance to look at the sheriff's department forensics regarding their Vic?
I fucking will if they fucking send them. I've called four fucking times.
Ooh, three fuckings in a row.
I can take inappropriate Masuka. I can take porn-loving Masuka. I can even take flatulent Masuka. But this dress you wearing, please and thank you, zombie Masuka, is fucking creeping me out.
Why did she say porn-loving and flatulent like it was a bad thing?
Exactly, right? I mean...
It's regular people things.
Yeah, regular people things, you know.
Maybe I'm realizing no one around here is my friend.
Mm.
The only time you people even acknowledge me is when you want something.
That's not so. We put you on our bowling team.
Only because you wanted to keep everyone's handicap higher to sandbag the other teams.
Okay, that's true, but...
I'm bad at bowling too.
Not one person read my paper. Not one fucking person showed up at the conference I spoke at.
Dang.
You hurt my feelings.
Oh, that's a real moment.
Yeah, that was the first time you saw Masuka ever get emotional like that.
Oh man, look, if you're a grown man saying you hurt my feelings, you are hurt for real.
Dude, right? I mean, the fact that he said that to Angel and to Deborah, it meant something because he thought they were his real friends.
But they couldn't even show up to his thing that was important to him,
right?
Look, brochures of houses.
Well, they're in great school districts, big yards, plenty of bedrooms, central air.
All I'm thinking is when my wife is telling me all her options of things that she wants to talk about, and I'm internally monologuing.
Right.
I'm sorry, but I don't want to look at houses. Mm. Not now, anyway.
If Syl and I go out to look tomorrow in the morning, can you watch Esther and Cody?
What's his excuse? Listen to his excuse.
I'm going fishing tomorrow.
Ooh. Wow.
Imagine if he said that. I can't watch our kids because I'm going fishing.
Wow, I wish.
I can't just drop everything at the last minute because you want me to.
That's fair.
There is one slight problem.
That's a big ass suit you got on back there.
Yeah, right?
Your case has nothing to do with our case.
Okay, here it comes. Here comes the line.
Not like our previous victims. There were minute traces of ink in the papillary and reticular.
Easy. Build it up.
It's all right here in the county medical examiner's report.
That's your opinion.
He's our lead forensic investigator, and there's no one better.
Oh, LFI.
See, they do love you.
Now they do.
Particular hemorrhaging in the eyes and bruising would lead one to conclude strangulation.
There it comes.
Unless you're me.
Give it to us. Come on. Come on.
Your victim was smothered. That's not opinion. That's science.
Ooh.
And science is one cold-hearted bitch with a 14-inch strap-on.
Yeah, big old strap-on.
That was a line right there. He's back.
Were you in the mirror being like, 14-inch strap-on?
Okay, so.
14-inch strap-on.
Tim, I think the original line was, science is one cold-hearted bitch with a strap-on.
Okay.
So I added not 10, not 12, 14.
That's
very specific.
Undeniably big.
Yes. So I changed that line, and I didn't tell anyone I was going to say it. I just said it. And it landed, you know?
Yeah.
Also, the rhythm of the line, science is one cold-hearted bitch with a strap-on.
Yeah, it needs that.
Versus,
for sure.
Science is one cold-hearted bitch with a 14-inch strap-on.
That's you like, know what I mean? That needs just, that little something, definitely.
The specificity is key.
14-inch strap-on. It just sounds better out the mouth.
14-inch strap-on.
And he's back.
Well, I think we're through here.
Was it ever hard for you to remember like the super specific anatomy lines and stuff? Like, you know,
Oh yeah, whole paragraph of like nitrogen oxide, mess with oxygen, whatever.
Are you like better at Jeopardy now? Like, were you like, what is capillaries?
We tried our best to sort of mimic the real thing, just so that there's some bit of...
Some type of accuracy,
accuracy,
for sure.
Right, exactly. But you know, for all the strip club stuff that Masuka had to deal with, that was all me.
Yeah.
I didn't have to do any research.
right. Or if you needed to, you're like, honey, I'm gonna go do some research for my role tonight, all right?
Gone all night. Uh-oh.
Here we go.
Uh-oh.
He's gonna kill him with a 14-inch strap on.
Oh. He's doing all of this on a cruise ship, by the way.
Oh, okay, I see. Oh, God.
I wonder, after all these killings that Michael did, do you think he ever got bored?
Yeah, what'd you do at work today? Just stabbed another person.
Bon voyage.
Oh, dismembered the body, threw it over the little round window.
Wow.
Remember that guy that I was telling you about whose wife disappeared on some cruise? Well, get this. He was reported missing about an hour ago.
Uh-oh.
Where was it that you say you went fishing?
Prado's onto something.
Mercy Reef.
Yeah, Mercy Reef. That's what I thought you said.
It's a great scene, right? Mm-hmm. The way it's written. Like, I know you know, you know I know.
Because when I sent the Coast Guard over there, they couldn't find you.
And we know that he knows.
Yeah.
Ocean's a big place.
Or maybe you weren't at Mercy Reef.
Do you know how crazy that sounds?
You were on that cruise ship. Finishing what I couldn't.
Shaggy.
I gave you the chance to avenge two women whom the system failed, and just like I hoped, you seized that opportunity.
Jimmy's so good.
Dexter. You don't have to lie to me.
He plays the scene so well.
I see who you are.
You can't. No one can.
You have nothing to explain to me.
Don't fall for
it. Oh my God.
Don't fall for it, bro.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
What's going on?
Don't fall for it, bro.
Prado's crazy too, bro.
Somehow he looks at me and he's proud.
Nice. I thought he was doing the thing my ex did when she was like, I know you were grinding on some girl at the club. And I was like, fine. She was like, oh my God, I didn't even know. I was tricking you. I was like, ah, you got me. Did you ever wish that maybe they turned your character into like a secret murderer or something?
You know, I mean, who?
Why didn't you go to my seminar?
Yeah, exactly, right? Who knew? Who knew? It could have gone that way.
I mean,
I didn't know if I was going to be dead or alive at the end of the season.
Right.
But I will tell you this though, right around season 3, maybe 4, I went into Michael C's, his trailer. Because I knew, like, people were fucking dying left and right.
Right.
I just had my second child. And it's like, hey, I gotta feed the kids, right?
Yeah.
So I went into Michael C. Hall's trailer. And
he's like, hey, what's up?
He's always like that.
Yeah. Hey, what's up?
I just went, Michael, you know, I had my second kid. He's like, oh yeah, hey, congrats. And I'm like, just wanted to say, it'd be really nice if you just kept me around long enough. As long as you could.
Yeah.
And he was like, huh, yeah, good one. All right. Whether he took it too hard or not, I survived.
But what you're not telling us is you had your hands around his neck when you were hey, man, I got a family to feed,
yeah,
man.
Exactly. Don't kill me off, Michael. Masuka needs to live.
Well, what a blessing, bro. 8 seasons, I know, that's amazing. Total blessing. When you first started, did you ever think that Dexter would go on to last this long?
Oh, hell no. Hell no. No one thought of that, you know. And now more. Mm-hmm. We got the prequel coming.
Amazing.
We got the resurrection coming.
Tight.
It's still fucking alive. Dexter, you're still alive.
And people really like serial killers.
Now they do.
They do.
They do. Well, they love the whole anti-hero.
Yeah.
Dexter was right there, like one of the original anti-heroes.
For sure, yeah. Was everybody like emotional last season?
Oh, I mean, yes and no. Because, you know, we were like a tight-knit family. We'd done 8 years together.
When you're like wrapping food in saran wrap, you get emotional? You're like, oh man, reminds me of a dead body.
Damn. Now every time I use saran wrap, I'm gonna be thinking of Dexter. God dang it. Maybe we should get a little saran wrap deal here. Yeah. What's going on, you know? Saran wrap. Everyone uses it, even Dexter.
Hey, all the original episodes of Dexter are airing on Paramount Plus with Showtime. Make sure you check it out, it's crazy.
Paramount Plus, Showtime, do it.